forget it was this kid for entering it. Let's just forgot to turn that one off. It's all good. Once you go through the portal, it's always a more peaceful state of mind. I've seen that in everyone who crosses through. In the
absolutely, yeah.
So if you're tripping beforehand, afterhand you'll be all right. Afterwards, you'll be all right. But a few more minutes. Got 10 more minutes.
We got 10?
Yeah. Oh, okay. I'm just, Rita's a little tired, you know. Jeremy's definitely tired. We just, you know, but please forgive us. I'm all right now, but let me see if I can think of, like, touch on some stuff here. Well, we had somebody ask a question about, like, this dude Mark wrote us asking about, I heard the phone. That was you. That was a message thing.
Yeah, message.
This dude Mark, you know who you are, wrote us asking about that he thinks he's hearing, people in his mind, talking and stuff like that, and he's trying to figure out where they're coming from. Or if it's just something going on in his own mind, Mark, I'll get in touch with you more specifically, but I'll write you back. But honestly, what you said here, I think it's something going on in your own mind with this situation. When they come through, it's a little bit different than how you described. It's going to be different than that. So, I think it's more, it's something going on manifesting in your own mind for some reason, which is not a bad thing, but when you'll know when it's a spirit, it's a little bit different feeling that's going to come through. That can go for anybody listening. When a spirit is communicating and you actually are hearing them, there's no mistaking that. When you're coming from the right state of mind of awareness, there's no mistaking that for anything else. You'll know. There shouldn't be any question. There's usually not any question at all. We had someone ask us about, she had heard footsteps through her house too, and footsteps and all of that. It turned out it was a ghost, but there's no need to be scared for any of you. If you hear stuff like that in your house or noises, don't be scared of it. It bears repeating again. Don't be scared of any of that. There's nothing to be afraid of. I've dealt with a lot of ghost type things, which are basically spirits who refuse the portal and, due to anger or other reasons, and then get stuck in a lot of lower dimension. So, I've had them around me before. One time I had a girl, a little girl, back in the winter. I think Jeremy, I know he remembers this. Like, I had a little girl that wanted to hang out with me because she loved it, playing with the cats. This is a little spirit. Maybe she was about 3 years old.
Yeah.
But she turned into a big annoyance, because, like, I couldn't get rid of her, basically. I couldn't get her to move on. All she wanted to do was hang around me and fly around my head, fly in circles around my head. And it was ruining the phone communication. Every time I tried to talk on my cell phone, she didn't fly around my head, and I couldn't talk because the signal would cut out. Eventually she moved on, but she hadn't crossed over either. It's like she hadn't moved on. She did move on eventually. I think Lord Buddha came through to help. I had to ask him for some help that time. But, they can disrupt electrical stuff. And I've had sensors blow out my car. One of Al Capone's hitmen. He blew out the radio in my car and the sensor one time through electrical charges, impulses. They can put out that. While we were crossing them over, we had some other things happen that day. Another spirit that was real negative came through, blew out some other stuff. The battery went dead suddenly, and then it blew out the brake sensor and all-wheel drive sensor. That dude was a serial killer who died in the 1920s, early 1915, 16. in Iowa. I think he was from Iowa. And it turned out this spirit of the ghost was a serial killer. The first one. The second one came right through with his Al Capone's hitman. One of them. Who didn't want to go to the portal because he thought he was going to hell. Both of them were like that. But they went through. You know, the Lord Buddha took those two through again. You know? But, what are you thinking about, Jeremy?
I don't know.
It's interesting stuff here. It's 4:57. We got a few things left, but we just wanted to say again, like, just keep these questions coming in, and don't be afraid to call us. And if we do get back with you today, we'll get back with you tomorrow. Sometimes things take longer than we expect, and sometimes things take a little longer than we think. Phone calls, sometimes it takes hours for us. One person could take hours. We don't mind at all. You know, I've had to talk to people for one person for hours before they were finally situated and learned needed to got through to them. You know, we do whatever it takes. Let me say that. We always are here for all of you as much as possible. This is our whole lives. We do this all full time. 7 days a week, we are constantly working, helping people. So, this is what we do. But, let me see if I made a note here about something yesterday. I was going to mention today. Yeah, tell us what you think about the role play things that are up here, where we are role playing what would happen in those in healing groups that we're working on starting. You know, there's a couple up there. We have better ones that we taped back the last winter and fall, but they're on a hard drive that is in a broken computer of mine, and the hard drive is a different type than the kind. It's an IDE hard drive, and the computer system I'm using now is SATA. A type SATA type connection, which is gonna, you have to get an adapter. It's gonna be difficult. I'm gonna have it done professionally before I can access all. There's a lot of data that I really need to get my hands on. So if any of you know, work on computers, hardware, build them or anything, and can handle this for me, call me 641-9082 anytime, and let me know how much you charge. You know. And, you know, I just need an ID, I guess ID adapter for a SATA system. It's a desktop, it's not a laptop, you know, and it's I just really need to get that hard drive installed as the backup, as a secondary hard drive on my new system. I've got to get into that hard drive. We've got tons of spiritual teaching videos and writings and role play videos, channeling videos, and more that are not up anywhere on any internet site, and I have no access to them except on that hard drive. It's already out of the computer. It's just sitting there. So it's just a matter of plugging it in and installing it on this new system. But please call me. I'd be happy to pay you. Just don't go. Hopefully it won't be like a crazy price, you know, but hopefully it can get done. But I guess we'll close out for here. We might just do one or two videos today instead of three. We've been turning there. We got a late start today, and a lot of stuff was going on. A lot of return calls. We still have to call someone in just a minute. So, but we're gonna let you all go for here. It's 5 p.m. on Thursday, the 8th. It's the 7th, isn't it?
Yeah,
no, it's the 8th. Not 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. No, it's 8. I'm sure it's the 8th. Yeah, it's July 8th. But anyway, we'll close it out for here. We're on the 20-minute thing. But just give us a call and write. Keep them coming.
All right, y'all. Peace.